walking right now is a state heritage preserve called Lewis Ocean Bay Heritage Preserve. The interesting thing about Lewis Ocean Bay is it's a real biological paradise, probably about 10 relatively rare carnivorous plants. The most important thing about this area is we're getting closer to the edge of this wetland over here. You can actually feel the ground start to get a little springy under your feet. You look down the ground, you see this nice light green carpet of peat moss. The reason why I think Venus flytraps tend to be associated with this is it holds a tremendous amount of water. And because it holds a tremendous amount of water, I think it makes a more constant moisture environment for the plants to grow. Another problem we have out here is people come out and try to dig these plants up all the time. It's illegal to do that in this preserve, but illegal poaching has been probably one of the biggest problems causing population declines of Venus flytraps, both here in South Carolina and in North Carolina. We often look at the records where Venus flytraps used to be found. We travel around to places where we know they were 10, 15 years ago, and instead of finding Venus flytraps, we find shopping centers, housing developments, golf courses, and things like that. People have noted for a number of years that the plant doesn't catch many flies. It catches more spiders and ants than flies. But about the only thing we can say is the name is stuck, and the name has persisted. And luckily, it seems as though the plant has also persisted in South Carolina. So as far as V is concerned, it must be in South Carolina, the Venus flytrap.